Hi everyone, thank you so much for stopping by. This is Deeptima. I look a little horrible today because I haven't slept really well. So you can see the dark circles, a lot of pigmentation on my face. And I think this is the perfect time to do this video. So this video was on my mind from a very long time because I have received requests, I have seen people wearing red lipsticks. And the color is beautiful, their features are beautiful. It's just that they have not taken care of other aspects of their face. So I've decided to make this video for you. If you are also scared of wearing red lipstick and if you feel it doesn't look good on you, just try the tips I would be giving in this video and let me know if it works for you. So it works for me, so I thought I should share it with you. And I am not a professional makeup artist. These are just some tricks that I've learned on YouTube. I've seen people doing these things, so I've picked up these tips and tricks on the way. So yeah, let's get started. So first let's just clean our face. And today I have decided to use this Clean O wipe. This one is charcoal detox and purifying facial wipe. So if you are following me on Instagram, you would know I did a giveaway on these as well, and I really like these wipes. So this is the charcoal one, it is a black wipe. So whenever I plan on wearing red lipstick, I like to clean my face nicely so that there is no residual liner or mascara or any product from the previous application. So first I would like you to examine your face. Like for me, you can see I have, let me zoom you in. So if you see really close up, you can see there's a lot of redness over here. I have like really sunken eyes right now. You can see a lot of darkness around my eyes. Over here, you can see the darkness as well. A little blue and green tinge on the upper lip area. And if I close my eyes, you can actually see the veins. I have like purple and red, blue. All the colors are there. I have like veins visible on the lids as well. You can see there is a lot going on my face. So number one step would be examining your face. See where you have darkness, where you have pigmentation. Because the key is to balance out your face. For example, if there is a bright object, your attention will go to that object first. And the bright object, the objects around the bright object would look even duller in that sense. Agar koi bahut bright object hai to uske aas paas ke jo objects hain wo aur zyada dull lagte hain, not because ki wo dull ho gaye, just because ki ek bright object center of attraction bana hua hai to uski brightness ke aage baaki cheeze dull lagne lag jati hain. To agar main aise hi without makeup abhi red lipstick laga lungi, so all these things like the redness, the depth, everything would look more visible, enhancing the flaws. It'll just enhance the flaws. So sara attention us beautiful red lipstick ke upar nahi jayega. All the attention would be on the discoloration and other aspect of the face. So it is very important for you to balance out the face. To uske liye sabse pehle you need to moisturize your face and cancel out the redness. Also, I have noticed people wearing bright red lipsticks, like bright beautiful colors, lekin no eyebrows. Eyebrows are so important. They frame your face. They give definition to your face. The eyebrows are really, really important. So I'm just using my Plum Illuminance Serum because my skin is dry. And just taking a little amount. I would not recommend this product to people with oily skin because this is just for people with dry skin. Next. I think today I'm going to use this Plum Age Renewal Serum. This is Cell Renewal Serum. Let's use something different for eyebrows today. I would be using this It Skin Eyebrow Pencil. It is called Baby Face Natural Eyebrow. It's a really nice product. I used to use it a lot. Then I stopped using it for some reason. I don't know. You don't want to make your eyebrows really dark, and I don't like very artificial looking eyebrows. Like, don't outline your eyebrow and fill it in. It is not, your face is not a sketchbook. Just fill in the gaps and blend it. Blend it. Blending is the key for eyebrows as well. I also thought this would be a perfect time for this video as the festive season is here and you guys must be busy with Durga Puja. Our Diwali is also here. People tend to wear red on Christmas and New Year. Red color is like a celebration color. This is what I feel. Shadiyo, maybe we always tend to wear red. Because red is such a happy, such a vibrant color, like a mood lifter, I would say. If I'm just planning on wearing red lipstick and I don't want too much makeup, what I like to do is cancel out the other colors on my face because you need a clean canvas. So, the baki colors hain face pe, jaise ki pink hai ya halka sa oranginess hai, ye sab ko cancel out karna is very, very important. So, for that, I would be using my LA Girl Pro Conceal. This one is light ivory. I also have another shade in, I think this is the yellow corrector. So, I'm gonna mix both of them. Going back to my favorite brush, the Earthy Ways A. The number has been erased. So this is the brush. This is how it looks. I really love this brush. I've said this enough in my videos. Thoda sa dirty hai, so don't mind that. And let's quickly start blending it. Do not forget the inner corners over here. Next, just taking a beauty blender, making sure everything is nice and blended. Thoda bahut pigmentation, thoda bahut redness has been taken care of. Next, I would use my concealer. This is the Wet n Wild concealer in the shade. Where is the shade? Light ivory again. And I'm just going to highlight the under eye area because it is looking a little yellow because I used yellow color corrector. So I'm just going to use little bit of the concealer. I'm just spreading it, not dragging it. Like just tapping it on my face. Also, if you lighten the center part of your face, the baki areas apne aap, they look contoured and dark. So good thing about just using concealer is that you don't have to spend a lot of time adding depth back to your face. You would not have to spend a lot of time contouring and bronzing and stuff. It just adds the right amount of light and the other parts, they automatically look a little pulled back. So it looks pretty good to me in the mirror. Doesn't look too caked up. So quickly let's set the under eyes. I'm using my Body Shop. This is the Japanese, the shade is Japanese Maple and it is matte clay powder. You can use anything that you have, guys. I'm just picking up whatever I can find near me. I love my under eye area to be matte. Yep, that's it. So now it's time to add some definition, some warmth back to our face. I really love the combination of Hoola Bronzer and Hoola Light. Sometimes I use my Wet n Wild Mega Glow Contour Palette. And so I'm going to take first the bronzer. Can you see the color? So I'm just going to blend it out. I use Hoola Light to blend the Hoola Bronzer. Hoola Light is really light. It might not be visible on darker complexions. So just changing my brush. That's a lot better. The brush I was using earlier was making the bronzer look really, really patchy. A little on that double chin. Although it's not gonna do anything about it. It just adds some definition to the face. That's it. Then I go in with my Hoola Light just to soften up the bronzer. I really love this. I don't know if you can see, there's a dent in it. Yes, I'm just swirling the brush all over my face. I would again say there are no rules to makeup. You do you, do whatever you want to do. You can have like really glittery, bright, bold eyes and wear a red lipstick. But I'm just showing you how you can wear, like this video is especially for those people who don't wear a lot of makeup but are really scared to wear red lipstick. So unke liye this would be beneficial. And this is also how I do my makeup when I'm wearing a red lipstick in like normal day-to-day life. And koi bahut bada occasion nahi hai, I just feel like wearing red. So this is how I do my makeup. So I'm going to take the Hoola bronzer. And because aankhon ke upar bhi concealer hai, to thoda definition wapas dalne ke liye. Otherwise your eyes can look really really small. Can you see that? I'm going in with the Wet n Wild thingy. Okay, these brushes are really good, guys. These are like Bougie Beauty. A few months back, I showed these brushes to you and I'm still using them. Kisi bhi brush ke baal nahi nikle hain. None of the brushes are broken or none of the brushes are shedding. And I have washed them I don't know how many times. So these brushes are really, really nice. I really like the eye brushes from the range. Even the face brushes are nice. I would say this one that I was using for the bronzer is also from Bougie Beauty. So these brushes are nice. I'll leave a link to the website in the description box for you to check out. Now, most Indian girls, they wear kajal. But for me, kajal doesn't look that good on me. And plus, I have lighter eyes. So what I like to do is, I like to just enhance the eyes by using some liner. So I'm gonna do a winged eyeliner really quick and I'll be right back. Also, I might wear false eyelashes. We don't know that yet. So I'll just do my eyes and I'll be right back. So the eyeliner is on, the lashes are on. You can see I did not make a really dramatic wing. The wing is quite short. I don't know if you can see it, like a tiny wing over there. And these eyelashes are PAC M72. These are Mink lashes. I had to trim like a good amount from the back because my eyes are so small. Really loving these eyelashes. They look so, so pretty. So let's get back to the topic. Now the face is done. Now we can have that bright pop of color. So I would say if you are from like light to fair complexion, go in for a blue toned or cool toned red. Now that color, like I don't believe that you have to wear a specific color according to your skin tone. But it's just that few shades and few tones, they tend to enhance your look. They tend to go really well with your complexion and undertones. So for someone who's light, who's fair to light, I think blue tone lipsticks looks really good. Even people who are very dark complexions ke upar bhi, a deeper purpley tone looks really, really good. It really looks beautiful on them. It just brings out their complexion. It works really well with the pigmented lips. With lighter complexions, your pink lips are kind of pink. So you want something with blue undertone. And the best part is it just makes your teeth look really nice and white and pearly. I have few options with me right here. And if you are like a medium complexion, you have a medium complexion, not too fair, not too dark, orange reds look really good on you. People who are light like me, orange reds tend to look more orange and coral on you because we already have that pink undertones. And on a medium complexion, the orange reds, they look really nice and they look very vibrant. Then again, as I said, darker complexions with like a blue toned purpley red or maybe like a cherry red color, these shades, they really, really look good on them. So I have like few options, as I was saying. This is from MAC. This is Lady Danger. This is a perfect example for orange red, which would suit medium complexion people. This is a really, really good color. On me, it just looks really orange. And I was wondering why the swatches I saw online are looking so different on me. Like, why is this lipstick looking different on me as compared to the swatches I saw online? Then this is Riri Woo. This is very similar to, I guess, Ruby Woo. I'm not sure. I don't have Ruby Woo. So this is Riri Woo. This is a really, really pretty color. And this would look good on a light complexion person. This is a cool toned but a darker red. I have two more over here. This color, these are from Lady Burgundy lipsticks. I really love these lipsticks. So look at the packaging. Just Just appreciate the packaging, guys. So this one, the darker one I have is a Rekha. I think let me swatch these for you. So my waxing is due, guys. Don't judge me. So the first shade I'm swatching for you is Lady Danger. Yeah. Lady Danger is like a orange red. Looks very orange on me. Next I have Riri Wu. Riri Wu is a matte formula. Comfortable on the lips but difficult to apply, I would say. Now this one. This is Riri Wu. Uske aage this is Lady Danger. From Lady Burgundy, this color, again, a gorgeous, gorgeous color. This would be perfect for medium to dark. This shade is Rekha. You see the wand, you can see like a magenta color. It is a deep cherry red. So this would look so beautiful on darker complexions. Wow. This color is so pretty. I don't know if you can see, but this is so, so, so pretty color. So pretty color. Such a pretty color. Next shade I have Rita. This is Rita. This is more of a cool toned red. Would be perfect for someone with fair complexion. It also has like purple undertones. So it will look good on people with medium complexion as well. Like fair to medium. Okay. Oh. Yeah, you can see it now. The last one that you see is Rita. Such a beautiful color. I'm gonna wear this and show you guys. I have two more reds from Sugar. This is Suede Secret Matte Lip Color. I have an entire video on this, so you can check that out. First shade is Satin Scarlet. This is a darker color. Again, a really beautiful cherry color. Cherry red. Very, very pretty. Next color I have is Terry Tomato. A really pretty color. This is more like in the warm family. So these are all the swatches. Let me zoom you in. Either go in with a red lip liner, line in your lips and apply a red lipstick. Or you can do is use a nude lip liner. This is what I do. Nude lip liner helps you to map out your lips better. And the two reds, they don't conflict with each other. So that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to use this lip shade from NYX. This is called Ever. And just quickly going to map out my lips. I would advise you to use lip balm before you start drawing in your lips. I forgot to use that. So I am using Rita from Lady Burgundy. Ah, I love the packaging. So let me just... I love this color. So once your red pout is ready, you can just fix the corners. Once the lipstick is dry, just fix the corners so that it is perfect. So yeah, you can see now, this is such a pretty color. I really love this color. Just brightens up your mood. It brightens up your face. And because you have something going on the eyes, your eyebrows are defined. It looks balanced. It doesn't look over the top. It doesn't look as if you're trying too hard. It doesn't look as if you are sick and just trying to pull off a red lipstick. It looks well put together. Because I was talking throughout the video, it took forever for me to do it. But this does not take time. It's like 5 minutes, maybe max 10 minutes and you're out of your house. What do you think of this look, guys? So let me just put on some highlighter. I don't wear highlighter that often, but I just love how it looks on camera. So I'm just gonna put a little highlighter over here. Highlighter I used was from Milani. If you are someone who is still scared of wearing red lipsticks, I really hope this video was helpful for you. I would urge you, I would really, really request you to try these tricks. Pull out your favorite shade of red, wear it, tag me in your photos on Instagram. You can even DM me your photos and I would love to see you in your favorite red lipstick. Don't feel shy. Red is the color of confidence. It's a color of power. And I really hope you like this video and you like this look. So if there is any other tip or trick that you have and you are already familiar with all that I have mentioned in this video, I would request you to please leave your tips in the comment section below, and I would love to try them as well. And I will leave now. Thank you so much for watching, guys. I love you a lot. And you can see just by applying this red color, my mood has changed. I'm like feeling really happy right now. But the sad truth is, I have to just go in the kitchen and make some lunch. So thank you so much for watching. I will talk to you very soon in the next video. Till then, take care. Lots of love, hugs, and kisses to you all. All the links would be in the description box with a direct link from where you can buy it. Some links might be affiliated. If it is Nykaa, the links would be affiliated. So just a disclaimer out there, and I'll see you very soon. Bye, guys.